Recorded Books Incorporated presents Pinky and Rex and the Spelling Bee by James Howe. Narrated by Christina Moore.
Chapter 1. The Big Day. Pinky could hardly believe it. The big day had arrived at last.
"Slow down," Rex said. "Why are you walking so fast?"
"I can't wait to get to school," said Pinky. "I've been getting ready all week."
Rex stopped walking.
"Getting ready for what?" she asked.
She didn't remember anything about there being a test that day.
"The spelling bee," said Pinky. "I love spelling bees."
"Oh, no," Rex cried. "I forgot all about it. I hate spelling bees. Do you think my mother would believe me if I told her I got sick on the way to school and had to come home?"
Pinky shook his head. Rex dropped to the ground and rested her chin on both hands. She did not look happy.
"Come on," Pinky said, picking up Rex's fallen book bag. "You can't stay here all day. Besides, you'll do all right."
Rex sighed.
"Pinky, you're my best friend. You're not supposed to lie to me. You know I'm terrible at spelling. I'm not going to do all right."
Sitting down next to Rex, Pinky said,
"So what if you're not good at spelling? It doesn't matter."
"That's easy for you to say," said Rex. "You're not going to make a fool of yourself. I hate looking stupid. It's bad enough to make mistakes when you're all by yourself. But when you have to stand up in front of the whole class, I just know everyone is going to laugh at me, Pinky. They'll laugh and they'll say, 'That Rex is so stupid.'"
"I won't laugh at you," Pinky told Rex. "And I won't think you're stupid either.
You're just saying that because you know you're smarter than I am."
"Maybe in some things I am," said Pinky. "But you're smarter in other things, like games. And you know lots more about dinosaurs than I do. You even know how to spell all their names."
This made Rex feel a little better.
"Maybe you're right," she said. "But I'll tell you one thing. If everybody laughs at me, I'm moving to the moon."
Chapter 2. The Champion Speller of the Whole Second Grade. Spelling was one thing Pinky knew he did better than anyone. He had never made a mistake. Not ever. Not on a test. Not in a spelling bee. He was the champion speller of the whole second grade. Sometimes this made Pinky nervous, but it made him feel special, too. He was so excited when the spelling bee began that he almost forgot how much Rex was dreading it. But then the teacher called Rex's name, and he saw the look on her face. He wished there was some way he could help his friend.
"Pencil," Rex repeated after the teacher.
Pinky noticed Rex's cheeks getting red.
Pencil. P-E-N-C-L-E. Pencil.
Some of the boys and girls began to snicker.
"Stop that," said Ms. Hernandez. "There's nothing funny about making a mistake.
That was a good try, Rex. Better luck next time."
"There won't be a next time," Rex muttered as she passed Pinky on the way back to her seat. "I'm moving to the moon right after school."
"Pinky," said Ms. Hernandez, "would you please spell Robin?" That's easy, Pinky thought. She must be saving the tough ones for later.
"Robin," he repeated. R-O-B-I-N, Robin.
"Very good," Ms. Hernandez said.
Pinky noticed the special way she smiled at him. After 20 minutes, there were only 6 children left in the spelling bee. Pinky looked up and down the line. He wasn't worried about Tanya or Marcy or Trevor or Ben. They were good spellers, but they weren't great spellers. However, at the far end of the line was a new boy named Anthony.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.